In this video, I'm going to talk about the Alar ligament test used in pre-manipulative screening for upper cervical spine instability.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Upper cervical spine instability has a prevalence rate of 0.6% according to Beck et al. In the year 2004. And is associated with inflammatory conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, as well as trauma and congenital deviations such as Down syndrome or Marfan's disease. In order to safely apply manual therapy techniques to the cervical area, it is necessary to screen for possible upper cervical instability. In their systematic review from Hütting et al. In the year 2013, they found a sensitivity ranging from 69% to 72% and a moderate to high specificity ranging from 96% to 100%. For this reason, the Alar ligament test has a moderate clinical value as a pre-manipulative screening test for upper cervical spine instability. The Alar ligament test is designed to test the quality of side bending and rotation between the occiput, atlas and axis. Insufficiency of the Alar ligaments creates hypermobility in this area. To perform the test, according to the description of Mintgen et al. In the year 2008, have your patient in supine lying position. Then the examiner grips and stabilizes spinous process of C2 and bends the head and atlas to the side and assesses range of motion and end feel. Repeat the process on both sides. If the Alar ligament is intact, only little to no side bending to the opposite side can occur and the end fill should be capsular. Then the test is repeated with rotation of the head and atlas on the axis and end fill and range of motion is assessed again. Excessive range of motion compared to the other side or soft end fill indicates a positive test. Alright, this was our video on the Alar ligament test for pre-manipulative testing of upper cervical instability. Next to the Alar ligament, it's important to test other cervical ligaments such as the transverse ligament on their integrity. Click on the video right next to me to learn how to do that. Thanks a lot for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video and you benefit from it in your studies or at work. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below if you still have any questions and subscribe if you haven't. You can find more information about us on Facebook, Instagram and on physiotutors.com. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.